This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you're having a blessed day in the Lord. I wanted to get up on here quickly because I'm getting ready to go into class, but I went to the store, and I'm sorry for the glare. I'm in the kitchen, and I guess I have a lot of lights on because I just got in from the store. Okay, so anyway, and it has to be something because I don't ever just jump on, but I had to jump on. And I'm going to post the pictures. I don't know. You know what? I'm going to have to do a second video so you guys can see the pictures. I'm going to send it to my email. Okay, so I'm just going to the post office, taking care of business like I do, and the Holy Spirit says, look up. Now, y'all know there's chemtrails that is always all over the world, but tonight I have never seen what I seen. It was like smoke in the sky, but it was like a squiggly thing, and it had about two of them, right? And it looked weird. So when I looked up, I said, God, that don't look right. He said, what do you think that is? I said, God, okay, it's not a chemtrail because chemtrails be white. I said, but God, what is that? He says, Deanna, they are opening more and more demonic portals. I said, my God, you guys, this stuff is real. Let me turn this off for a minute. They are opening up more portals. What does that mean? I'm going to have to go here. I don't have time to play games. Excuse me. We're not doing our job. Because I asked God, I said, God, what's going on? He said, there's an off balance. And I'm telling you what thus said the Lord. I don't care who don't believe. At this point, I don't even care no more. I don't care what nobody say, what nobody believe. I know why I hear it, okay? God said, Deanna, y'all got to start praying more. He said, I'm going to tell you what's wrong with the body of Christ. He said, y'all busy trying to get money and be famous and be well known. I'm telling you what he said. Hallelujah. He said, the body of Christ. He said, y'all so indwelled with all this other stuff. Because God don't look at us individually. I know y'all think he does, right? No, he looks at us, the body of Christ, the children of Israel. Got to come back to your first love. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. There is no reason that evil should be written in this hour. Not with the power of God. It's not on God because God is God. Hallelujah. I feel the power of God. Don't matter. Hallelujah. God is God. So it's not God. But I told y'all, and I wish I had more time to explain this. God cannot do everything because he's given us dominion. So that means he looks for people in the earth who's pure, who's powerful, who's serving me for real. I'm not talking about for play. Oh, I'm about to go here. Hallelujah. I'm going to have to get back on here because I got to go to class. I'm going to have to get back on here. But let me tell y'all something. When you can feel the power and the presence of God, that's God. I'm not talking about. Let me tell you something. It's too many Christians that are in between. I'm not saying they don't love God. I'm not saying that they don't try to serve God. But you and I both know they compromise. Oh, I'm going here. I'm going here. Everything is supposed to be holy. Holy Bible, Holy God, Holy Spirit. When you got a question, if it's holy, if it's God, that ain't God. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I'm going here. From the gospel music to the gospel television shows. If it is, I'm just going to tell y'all what God said. We're starting to look like the world. You can't tell the difference. And y'all think it's a good thing. I'm just going to be real with you. No, it's not. There should be some distinction, said the Lord. Hallelujah. He said, my people shall wear my stripes. That my people shall wear my anointing. My people shall wear my bloodstained banner. You know why the 12 apostles were so powerful? Because they wore that banner day and night. And they knew they was going to die for it. They knew that. They didn't care who liked them. If they were famous. As a matter of fact, they ain't hardly have nothing. But we have a church that want to have everything. But you ain't saving nobody. You ain't helping bringing people to Christ for real. It's a facade now. Y'all know it's real. It's a facade. I promise y'all don't want to be part of that facade. Let me tell y'all something. I do everything independent now, from my music to my books to everything. I don't want no part of it. That's right. Y'all think I'm playing. I don't want no part of it. I say none of it. I don't have to be famous. Long as my message, which means it's the messenger of God, long as he used me, that's what this is about. This ain't about y'all done made it too big. And the first thing if somebody says something, oh, they hating on what? Hating on somebody that's compromising because they want to be. That the devil is a lie. Miss me with all that. Miss me with that. I just want to be used by God. I just want somebody to be touched by God. I just want somebody to be saved by God. I didn't say we were perfect. We're not. Don't even get that illusion or that delusion. But as long as you love God and you try your best, now you're going to have your good days and you're going to have your bad days. Or you're going to have some days where you don't want no part of God. And I'm not saying that like you don't love God, just God, I can't do this today. Or I'm going to be the only one to tell you. Just lay in the bed, you just, I just, and God will say, rest, but you can't quit. God will say, rest if you must, but you can't quit because this is not about you. Hallelujah. This stuff real. Anyway, I got to go. I'm telling you, those portals, I never saw nothing like that. I'm 50 years old, about to be 51 this year. I've never seen what I saw in that sky. And it was scary. And you're going to see, I'm trying to drive, but, you know, you got to be careful. And I'm trying to take, and then, you know, then this guy came out of nowhere. You know what I'm saying? I was like, okay, I'm going to have to put this phone guard. I'm put this phone down. I'm trying to take pictures. So then I went back to the parking lot, and I did take a little video. And then all of a sudden it got dark. I said, they think they slick, but I still got some footage. You guys, we in that time. You know, the closer I get to God, I hear God say, Deanna, people don't want to sacrifice no more. He said they're scared to die. He said, just like Jesus went through, that's what they're going to have to go through, and y'all scared. And I get it, because the stories I tell y'all, they true. If I told y'all what'd be happening at night up in my home, I ain't scared. I'm sorry, I just don't have that in my body. I didn't have it when I was unsaved. I'd be doggone if I'm gonna get in Christ and then all of a sudden act like I'm scared. And that's what y'all, and hold on though. I can't glorify myself. It's only through the glory of God. It's only through the favor of God, the power of God, that I could stand and look in the enemy and say, that's all y'all got. So I know y'all listening to me. I know y'all watching me. I know y'all following me. The most people you say that to, they'll be like, ooh. And be honest, when I first started talking about this stuff on Facebook, people used to inbox me, oh, be careful. Watch what you say. Well, it's too late. They already got my little name. And I ain't scared. Because what y'all don't understand, I was 27 years old, 1996. I never forget. I did not understand it then. God showed me my death. And, you know, I thought I was tripping. I realize I'm not now. I gladly die for God. I ain't scared. They gonna have to do me that straight up because I'm not compromising. And hold on. This is a whole video. I'm not compromising. So most people, they compromise. And they do it so subtle that you don't even see it, but you feel it. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. That's why I don't roll with everybody that said it. As a matter of fact, the Bible say in Revelations, they'll say, Lord, Lord. And he said, everybody that said, Lord, Lord, don't belong to me. Y'all wonder why there's such a falling away? Because most of the people that's preaching and teaching don't belong to God. Because when you belong to God, I'm going here now. I got to get off of here. You can't just, I can't turn back. Y'all don't understand. I don't ever want to fall. But no matter what happened, I can't never turn back. It behooves me how a person can walk with God. And all of a sudden, you don't or you can't. The devil is a liar, and so is you. Because the power of God, it'll hit you in that bed. It'll hit you in the bathroom. It'll hit you at work. It'll hit you in your car. You can't run from God. You can't stop the power of God. You can't stop the presence of God. Hallelujah. When I realized who I was telling the testimony today. Let me tell y'all why I do it. I never forget, I was in Sacramento, California. And I was staying on Feather River Court. I remember the address I was staying at in California in a nice home. And I never forget what God told me when he told me to start saying, thus saith the Lord. And I'm going here. I had something to say about T.D. Jakes and a couple other people. And I cried. And God was like, why are you crying over them? He said, do you love them more than you love me? I said, God, I start saying, thus saith the Lord. They're not going to like me. He said, Dan, who are you more worried about? And I'm not going to lie, me and God, I called myself fussing with God that whole night and I cried. He said, no, Deanna, they're not going to like you. He said, no, Deanna, the world would not accept you. He said, no, Deanna, you would not go where you thought you was going to go. No, Deanna, I mean, it was no to a lot of stuff. And I cried, and I cried. Y'all know that song, that I cried that whole night. And I remember that morning about 3 or 4. I said, God, I love you. I said, so whatever I got to go through, the mockery, the loneliness, y'all don't hear me. Because when you really do this for real, everybody ain't rolling with you. They think you're crazy. Or better yet, they scared. Because they know what you tell. There's one thing I've noticed. the truth hit you in your spirit. Them people really watching me. Them people really do. So you really think, I'm finna go here. Whoever God sent, and that's if he sent somebody to be in my life, that person will have to be strong like me. Because the average man, I'm not messing with that girl. That girl said people going in the house watching her. Y'all ain't ready for me. You think it's a game? So I got to be strong. I love you, God. I serve you, God. You see, and I'm going to get off of here. All we did was trade places with Jesus. But we don't want to touch that. We want to wear the little bracelet. What would Jesus do? We want to be in church. We want to speak in tongues. But we don't want to go through what he went through. Hallelujah. Look what they did him. Look what they did him. And he opened not his mouth. We don't want to go that far. Oh, no, we'll go just enough to let people know. But the real ones, we'll go to that cross with Jesus, just like the apostles did. And to be honest with you, that is what is required. And that's why some of y'all, you only go a little bit and then you back up because you already know what's awaiting you. But I'm like this, you're going to die anyway. Either you die in Christ or you die and go to hell. And I know people don't like when you put it like that because we live in a world, well, don't say that, don't do this. You do, you have to say it so rough? Yeah, I got to say it just like it is. Hallelujah, the blood would not be on my hand. So God bless you. God keep you. And I know I give some hard that says, Lord, I get it. Trust me. I understand. But this is to build you up in the most holy faith. Time out for playing games, God says. If you're going to take up your cross, then take up your cross to reward and quit playing with God. Hallelujah. So, all right. God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. Roll our soldiers, for that is who we are. God bless.